Okay, if you're here to see how I'm going to tie in a bathtub hot and a bathtub, or a bathtub and shower, I guess, hot and cold, then you're in the right did, and then I dug it from the meter all the way to right here. And this is just white PEX coming out of the ground, and it just goes 2 feet underneath the house and kicks up right there. All it does, the cold water comes in the house right there. It runs over here to the hot water heater closet and 90s up the wall there. And it goes into this closet. And once it comes out of the hot water heater, it comes down right beside it, and that's hot now. And I've capped it right here, and all I've done is run all my hot lines off of it. One for the sink, one for the vanity, and now one for the bathtub. You're gonna need some red PEX and some blue PEX. Blue is cold, red is hot. Here are some fittings that are common fittings that you're gonna need. You might wanna look at those. So here they are. These are 3/4 inch 90s tees and couplings, 1/2 inch tees, couplings, and 90s. And then I've got some random ones right here. Some at 3/4 to 1/2, 3/4 to 1/2, 3/4 to 1/2, blah, 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 blah. And then you'll need a tape measure, some rings. And these are clips to nail them to the 2x4s. And these are not cashews, they're screws. And this is to drill the holes for the pipes, a DeWalt drill, and another DeWalt drill for putting the screws in. Then you can use a hammer and nails if it's a cheaper option if you don't have this set up. Here is the crimp tool. I think it's like 70 bucks or something. Here's the cutters, they're pretty cheap, and a tape measure. That's all the stuff you're gonna need. So let's stick around and see how easy this is. I need for the red, and how long of a piece I need for the blue to get from where I'm going, which is right here, and I'll take you in close in a minute, to where the tub's gonna be. So that's all I'm gonna do, is get that stretch from there to there, and then I'm gonna get a stretch from where it is there, and how long of a piece, which I know it's 3 feet, that goes up through the floor. So I need a 3 foot stretch that goes up, and that'll be connected with a 90 going over to here. So let's do this. I'll show you how I stretch this pipe out. It kind of bends. It's kind of, you know, flexible, so, and it's rounded first in a tube like this. So I just kind of bend it the opposite way like this. And it's 8 degrees right now, so this is like super stiff, but, you know, usually it wouldn't be this stiff, but you just do the same way. Super cold right now. Okay, let's see how long of a piece I need. So I need to cut it right here and go back and forth gently and squeeze gently until it cuts all the way through. That'll get you a clean cut. Is get the 2 3-foot pieces. I'm gonna get the 2 3-foot pieces ready now. And I'm gonna go ahead and crimp the 90s on those pieces right now. So I'm gonna measure these. Let's crimp those 90s on there. I'm gonna show you how I crimp these 90s on. So come in close. Okay, so here's all you need. The crimp tool, this fitting, 3/4 to 1/2 inch. I got a 1/2 inch T, some 1/2 inch 90s. That's all I got. So let's put these 90s on here. All I'm gonna do, right there, the ring on first, on the blue, and the ring on first, on the red. And this is actually not a straight cut. So I'm gonna recut this. Okay, so ring first, and then you put the T on. And it just goes on there like that. Okay, and slide that ring up, and then get your other one ready. Then all you do is you take this tool, You open it up all the way and you put it on here. And you clamp it gently at first, make sure it's straight. It is. So now I'm gonna close it in. It's closed in all the way. Make sure you clamp it down all the way. And I'm gonna set this aside. Okay, that one's done. Okay, so what I have here is the 90s on here. I'm gonna take that drill, pop a couple of holes and drop those through there. They're pinned up right here on this little board and I'm gonna cut them to length when I'm ready. One right here, this 3/4 to 1/2 inch fitting. I'm gonna cut this off with the cutters and I'll do it right now. Just like this. And slowly, I jacked that up, guys. Let me set this down. There we go. Let's cut through. And all we're gonna do is take a 3/4 inch ring instead of a 1/2 inch ring. It's the same exact way. Slide that on there first. And then I'm gonna take that special fitting, this fitting right here. And it's gonna go on there, 3/4 inch, and it drops to a 1/2 inch. First, I'm gonna crimp this before I forget. Same way as you do the half. These 3/4 inch ones are not very easily to squeeze. Okay, now here's the 1/2 inch one. And remember, this is the red piece, pre-cut. I'm gonna go underneath the house like this, and it'll go on there. But first, what do we gotta do? We gotta put a ring on. Put a ring on it first. And then insert it. Ready, right there. Okay, that's 3/4 to 1/2 inch right there. It's set up. I'm gonna put a tack right here. Just like this. And I'm gonna tack this, up right here. And there was a cap here, but now it goes down and the pipe goes down to a 1/2 inch and runs over to here. Right here. There. I'm gonna put a ring on it just like that. And I'm gonna, now that there's a ring on there, I'm gonna insert just like that. You can think. Okay, there we go. That's on there. And that's gonna go down and up through my little bracket. And now we've got it where we want it right there. And you see, we have a cold pipe. I'm actually gonna need to take you to about right here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut it right here. This is the cold line. It comes up out of the ground right over there, about a foot over. And now I'm gonna cut it right here. And all I'm doing is taking this special fitting right here. It's a 1/2 inch. Or a 3/4 inch, 3/4 inch to a 1/2 inch tee. Here comes the rings. And put the ring on it first. Connecting now to here. And I'm gonna crimp it. Like that,
and I'm gonna crimp this one. Okay. Now, I need to take you over here. So I have this one coming in from that one now. I'm gonna put a ring on it. Right there. We need another piece. All right, now that's on there, and I'm gonna get to a couple of clips, and we're gonna tack this all up. We're gonna tack this one up here. All right, now all of this is tacked up. Okay, I've got all this tacked up now, and I have other videos on how I hooked up the sink and the kitchen sink, the vanity, the toilet, all these drains, if you want to check into all those other videos. But this is done now. This is coming from the main outside. Comes from outside right there, pops up, goes to the there, comes out hot, runs to everything. We connected right here. It ran over here to the hot. It stubbed up, and that's all I've done. Now I can put my subfloor.